The American dream for Pininfarina started very early, in the early 20s, even before then the company was established. My grandfather, Battista Pininfarina, went to visit the four factories and he spent about 2 weeks around the offices and the plants. And at the end of those 2 weeks, he had a lunch with Henry Ford and he was asked to become the chief stylist, the director of styling for Ford Motor Company. He said, thank you very much, but I have other ideas in my mind. 1947, the Cis Italia is a milestone for Pininfarina, for Italian design. It was an outstanding international success. My grandfather became popular and famous worldwide, also here in the US. My grandfather really wanted to create a partnership here in the US, and he succeeded with Nash, created the Nash Ambassador Cabriolet, and in 1951 he came here to promote the car, and he was displayed as the master of Italian style coming to America. There are pictures of him here in New York, taken from the island of the Statue of Liberty with the backdrop of the downtown. Now we are launching the first project of Automobili Pininfarina. I said that we have this dream to have a Pininfarina car on the streets, and I think that there is the chance that this dream will become true in the near future. And then we announced the project officially in Rome for the first Formula E Grand Prix in April, and now I am in New York for the Formula E in New York. I like to remember this dream and this connection, this story between Pininfarina and the United States, and the next step in Pebble Beach in August.